guys, welcome back to Ms. Kiefer's Living Room. The purpose of today's video is to kind of just give a step-by-step tutorial of how to solve the odd number problems on your worksheet because, you know, answer keys can only give you so much, but just hearing someone explain the actual problems that you are going through might make things a little bit easier. So feel free to skip around. Some of the problems are going to be a little easier than others, or you can just listen to the same thing and follow through, and then take your shot at doing the even number problems. All right, so for number one, we're going to treat numbers as numbers. So when it says multiply 2 times 2, that gives me 4. And it's the multiplicative rule of power, so I'm going to add the power because they're the same base, which is m. So now I just have 4m to the power of 5. Number 3, right, I'm going to treat it as such, which is 8. And then r to the power of negative 3 plus r, or times r to the power of 2, remember we're adding the powers, which gives us r to the negative 1, which again, I only want exponents in positive form. So this becomes 8 times 1 over r, because r to the power of 1 is just r, which is simplified to 8 over r, okay? For this next one, same thing applies. We're going to do 4 times 2, which is 8, and then we're going to add the powers. All right, it's pretty simple. Now for 7, same thing, we're only going to worry about the numbers, because if you notice, we can't really do anything with the variables because they don't have the same base. So I'm going to have 3 times 2, which is 6. And then this next thing is kind of just mathematicians like to write it in alphabetical order. So you're going to see it written as 6xy squared. It doesn't matter if you put y squared first, but again, you're just going to see it always in alphabetical order. But of course, it's a community property, we can change that order. This next one, same thing. Even though it has negatives, I'm still going to use the multiplicative rule. So I have 12, right, because 4 times 3, a cubed times a to the power of negative 4. Remember, we're adding those powers, so that becomes negative 1. Same thing, this becomes b to the power of negative 1, which is equal to 12 over a times b. I kind of skipped the step over here because I know it's just the reciprocal, it's 1 over, right, the positive, and so I can just write it as such. 11, we're moving into the power rule. So again, I'm distributing everything within those parentheses, and I'm multiplying the powers, not adding the powers. So this is x to the power of 2 to the power of 0, which becomes x to the 0, or in other words, becomes just 1, because anything to the power of 0 is going to be 1. Okay, next one, 13, same thing, but remember that power rule, I'm going to distribute everything in that, within the parentheses with that power. So I really have 4 to the power of 4. And then I have r to the 0 because 0 times 4 is 0. And so then I know 4 to the power of 4 is 256. And then r to the power of 0, again, just becomes 1. So my answer is 256. As I mentioned in previous videos, we could write 4 to the power of 4, but again, sometimes if it's an easy or a small enough number, we can go ahead and evaluate it right in standard form. All right, 15, again, same thing, dealing with that power rule. I'm going to do 3 to the power of 4, which again, we'll talk about in a little bit. And then we have power of 16, because 4 times 4 is 16, which gives me, I know that 3 to the power of 4 is 81, and then k to the 16th. next one, same thing, we're still dealing with the power rule. So now I have 2 to the power of negative 1 times b to the power of negative 4, because I'm, again, multiplying those powers. And again, if you see anything that doesn't have a power, you're going to assume it's just 1, because anything to the power of 1 is itself. So now I know 2 to the power of negative 1 is 1/2. And then b to the power of negative 4, same thing as that reciprocal. So it's b to the power of 4. And that's the answer. Okay? So I'm going to write the backside. And actually 17 was the first problem on the backside, if you're following along. And then I'm just going to rewrite them as we go along. Okay? So bear with me. You might hear some music in the background because I feel like it's really weird just talking with complete silence, which is kind of, I want to say, ironic, because most of the times teachers are, you know, telling you all to be quiet while they're talking. But I mean, also I'm talking to my iPad and not, you know, a room full of 32 students. So just lots of things you take for granted. Okay, so moving on. I'm actually gonna use my black marker again. All right, so I just did 17, so now we're on to 19. So 19 is 2x to the power of 4, y to the power of negative 3, all raised to negative 1. Same thing as we've been doing, the power rule, which should that power of everything in the parentheses, so it's 2 to the power of negative 1, x to the power of negative 4, and y to the power of 3. Okay, same thing, I'm going to make sure I only have an answer of positive exponents, and so this one becomes y cubed over, oops, I'm going to put my 2 there, 2 to the power of x to the 4th. And so I skipped a step because this really translates to 1/2 times 1 over x to the 4th times y cubed. But again, years of, you know, practice, I know that the y cubed is going to be my denominator because it's the only positive exponent right here, and then everything else is a negative, so I immediately know it goes to the denominator. But again, if you take that extra step, it's not going to hurt you. Take all the time that you need. Alright, moving on to 21. So 21 is r squared over 2 r to the power of 3. So now we're getting to our quotient rule. So now I still have 1 over 2, because 2 is the denominator, so we can assume that there's a 1 there. And so now I have 2 minus 3, which gives me negative 1, so I have r to the power of negative 1. Also, if you've been noticing when we've been dealing with the negatives, especially when we're using the quotient rule, I was taught and I also have learned that if you do the quotient rule, and there's a greater power in the bottom, right? You can assume, especially after, you know, converting this back or doing the expansion, right? This really becomes r to the power of 1. Right, my little fraction bar is a little slanted. Okay, so this is my answer. And again, anything to the power of 1 is just itself. All right, moving on to 23. So 23 is 3n to the power of 4 all over 3n cubed. Same thing, we treat the numbers as such, the division. So 3 over 3 becomes 1. So I'm just gonna write that so we can keep track that that's what we did. And now I'm gonna subtract my powers because it's the quotient rule. So now I just get n to the power of 1, and again, 1 has that, you know, magic property, so this is really just n. Moving on to lucky 25, because Miss Kiefer is 25 now. We have 3m to the power of negative 4 all over m to the power of 3. Same thing, I'm just going to use a quotient rule. So I have negative 4 minus 3. So now I have 3m to the power of negative 7, which I know becomes 3 all over m to the power of 7. All right. Okay, just two more problems. The next one we have is 27, which is 4x to the power of 0, y to the power of negative 2, z cubed all over 4 to the x. 4 times x. Okay, so immediately what I can notice is that we have two variables that don't have anything in the denominator, so I'm not applying the quotient rule. And if you notice, 4 times x to the power of 0 really just becomes 1, right? So now I really just have 4 over 4, which is 1, right? I have y squared, or y to the power of negative 2, I should say, right? And then z cubed all over x, because again, 4 divided by 4, I have my lonely x. The only thing that I have to do next is to make sure I convert a positive x or negative exponents into positive. Right, so now I know it's going to be z cubed all by itself in the top, and then x y squared. Right, and then last one, 29. 29 seems a little daunting, but again, we're just applying the rules to the numbers or the variables that contain the same base. All right, so again, if you notice, they're all written in alphabetical order. 4/3 can't be simplified any further, so it's gonna stay as such. And I'm just gonna kinda extend my fraction bar because I know that some of it's going to contain other variables. So I have the m's now, so m to the power of 4 over m squared. So I subtract my powers, so I get a positive m squared. All right, with the n's, I'm just subtracting 3 minus 2, which is just n. And again, I'm going to notice that 3 minus 4 is negative 1, which we know p to the negative 1 is going to be a positive p in the denominator. Great. So hopefully this helped. As usual, I'm available by email as well as our Google Meets if you have any questions.